YouTube, what is up? What is good? It's the boy Nate, and today we got a nice different kind of change of video here. We got a collab with my guy Malachi. Say what's up.
How you doing, everyone? Like Nate said, my name is Malachi. Malachi Burden. If you don't know me, I'm in Houston. I'm from Baltimore, but me and Nate went to Penn State together. My channel is Stay Prayed Up. And I'm just gonna want to shout him out for this collaboration. As you know, he kind of came to me with the idea, and you know, here we go, here we are putting it all together.
And today we're gonna get to a myriad of different topics. But first, if you're new to either of our channels, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to both. This is gonna be first of maybe hopefully many collab videos. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And hit the notification bell so you miss any uploads for either one of our channels.
Yes, follow me on my channel, Stay Prayed Up. That's the name of it, Stay Prayed Up. And my channel is mainly on spiritual, mental, emotional growth, and you know, overall personal growth. You know, you don't have to be any religion to follow me. It's really for all people. But you know, I think that you know, at times we focus on financial gains a lot and tangible items in life, but we don't realize that you know our spiritual, emotional, mental health is just as important as our physical and financial health as well. So I'm glad that we have this opportunity to utilize both our platforms and both our in a sense ministries to reach a larger audience together.
So our first topic we're gonna dive into is the one that's been all around the news. It's been everywhere. And that's the coronavirus. Yes, so pretty much 2020 has been just essentially dominated by the coronavirus. Obviously started overseas. Now pretty much in the United States has been closing everything down, from schools to businesses restricting travel. And now they got the NBA, the NHL, MLB have all suspended their seasons so far. So as you know, like basketball and hockey are now towards the end of the seasons, but they suspended indefinitely until further notice. And then MLB suspended all spring training games and actually delayed the start of baseball season for the first 2 weeks. So this coronavirus has been crazy. It's been this, I guess it's had like everybody like in fear. So it's kind of just like one of those things like, man, like it's like, how serious is it? Like, is it more serious than the media is saying? Or everybody just being overhyped about it? That's the kind of like the main question. Also, for the conspiracy theorists out there, we know every 4 years, like every presidential like election year, there's been a major virus. This year's coronavirus, 2016 was Ebola, and 2012 was the swine flu, or I believe it was the other name was the H1N1. Just to, you know, if you know, you know.
My thoughts on the coronavirus are, I got maybe a little bit more different. I think that this is a good time, and I'm not trying to sound too spiritual or preachy, but just walking by faith and not by sight. And what I mean by that is I think in today's world, we're allowing social media to influence our daily decisions. If you just kind of look at a larger scope from other pandemics and other diseases and viruses that have kind of plagued mankind since the beginning, in respect to everything else and the magnitude of death first, I guess coming into contact and actually being, sick or contaminated, whatever the word is, with it, like the rate is very, very, very low compared to other pandemics that have had millions and millions of deaths. And, you know, and you have doctors and other medical professionals like pretty much combating the media, but yet the media is still just forcing out all this negative or inaccurate data, and you know, all of us are just like eating it up. And now you just kind of see grocery stores you see all these grocery stores just you know, going out of stock, and then it trickled down to the sports, and then from sports it went down to other cities, and now like entire colleges are shut down, NCAA is shut down, professional leagues are shut down, cities are starting to shut down, restaurants and all that. And it's, you know, laws is just from the media. If you actually just take a step back and relax and realize actually what's going on. We've been in a very much prepared situation, except now we're relying on our emotion that are driving our decision instead of actually sitting back and making logical decisions. And to wrap everything up, I want to leave you all with this quote. It reads, "What you feed grows, what you focus on expands, and what you meditate on manifests." And that's for positive and negative things. If you breed negative thoughts, you're going to get negative results. If you breed positive thoughts, you're going to breed positive results.
But yeah, the coronavirus has been going crazy. Coronavirus has been just shutting everything down, and now it's actually infiltrated into college sports because now no March Madness, and then also like a lot of like other schools that has been all athletics completely, which means Penn State won't have their blue and white game, which is sucks for the seniors there. You know, the seniors go through, you know, obviously the 4 years or 5 years or 6 years, and they just want to be able to enjoy the last blue and white weekend, like the last legendary weekend of their, you know, college, you know, well, the undergrad college. And that sucks, you know, and especially like all of those like senior athletes, because obviously, you know, Penn State basketball had a good season. It's going to be tournament bound for the first time in, I believe, since 2011 or 2012. So, and then like a lot of like Penn State wrestling, like all the winter and spring sports are canceled. So that's just, I can only imagine, you know, working hard, you know, like in the off season, when, you know, all students are away, you're still like at campus, you know, putting in like hard work as a student athlete. And it's like, man, you had a great season, go to the tournament. It's like, well, can't compete because coronavirus canceled. So it's kind of like, man, it sucks. And then obviously, like I said, blue and white weekend, everything's just, you know, it's canceled. But that doesn't mean you still can't have a good time. That doesn't mean you still can't, you know, find ways to enjoy yourself amongst, I guess, a small group of friends. It is like that, so.
Yes, going back to what Nate said, for blue and white, if you're not for Penn State, it's just an alumni weekend, pretty much like a spring semester homecoming. And I was, you know, planning on going. I already have my plane tickets, everything, so I have to get that squared away and situated. But, you know, just going back to college sports and, you know, athletes who, you know, this season from the winter and spring semester got their seasons cut short. Not only that, but if you look at corporate America and, you know, people not being able to work and, you know, people who can't work remote, and how that's affecting the stock market and the daily economy, where we think that the daily economy and the stock market doesn't affect our daily lives. And when you work in jobs, especially for me in oil and gas, you kind of see how that trickles down all the way down from larger corporations all the way to our daily goods that we buy at the supermarket. And not only that, but just thinking about kids who go to schools for who get free lunch and stuff like that. So what happens to them? And then even that, you know, people who do lose their jobs, who work regular 9-to-5s in restaurants or other bars or clubs, and now they can't work. You know, taking all that into consideration, there is, you know, the fact that the media is kind of pushing this is really altering the daily lives of millions and millions of people who now are out of jobs or are not getting food when they were on a regular basis.
And also at the same time, you get like enjoy yourself, and that's kind of like, you know, a little gateway to what I'm gonna talk about next. Is like just pretty much having to like be, like now since like you can't really like do me like social gatherings in like the short period, the foreseeable future. You pretty much gotta like learn how to do things by yourself. So maybe, you know, try to like do like, obviously do more stuff at home. Like, you know, maybe like learn new skill online. Like learn a new language like Spanish, French, or just learn like new computer skills. Maybe like a new coding language, or just how to this even basic stuff. Like learn more about Microsoft Office, or read more books about like, you know, how to be either entrepreneur and success, or even how to be more confident. Or, I mean, it could be like one of us, you know, start, but you know, turn on the camera. You could be an iPhone camera. It could be like an old digital camera that you might have and start filming videos. You never know. So, there's definitely like, I see there's a lot of panic. There's a lot of like, oh man, like, I don't want to get sick, so I gotta stay inside. But what I'm gonna do while I'm inside? There's tons of things you can do inside. Just, you know, browse around or even get out of your comfort zone a little bit and just try to make the best of this current situation. Just just try to all find ways to improve yourself. That's the pretty much the key in everyday life. Just no matter what's going on, no matter what you're going through, just continue just to push, continue to just find ways to just improve yourself and just continue to be yourself, continue to be great.
Yes, I think this is the perfect time to not to waste. You know, we're all home, so I think that, you know, we have a lot more free time, and working from home sometimes slows down our daily tasks a little bit. So, you know, on your free time, you know, start reading books, start listening to audiobooks. You know, it's so cliche, but we really all have the same 24 hours, you know. We have the ability to, we have so much knowledge out there to, you know, if you're cooking, if you're taking a shower, if you're getting ready in the morning, like put on a YouTube video or put on an audio book or something that you can do while feeding your mind and continually growing, like at all times, constantly growing. And, you know, if you're reading if you're eating something or taking a break, like read a book at the same time. It's so much knowledge out there to grow. And it doesn't have to be a financial knowledge. It could be on any topic that you want. Like, you should never stop growing in life. The moment you decide to stop growing is when you're dying. This is also a good time just to reach out to family and friends. And, you know, I think back to the Kobe Bryant death situation. It was, you never know when your time is coming. You don't, regardless if you're successful or not, regardless if you're rich or you're poor or, you know, middle class, it really doesn't matter. When your time comes, your time comes. So I think that this is even a good time. Now, we're all home, we're all on our phones, we're on our laptops. Like, just send a simple text, you know. It doesn't take that long. I think we take time for granted so many times that when a big situation occurs, then we want to start being proactive with our time and start reaching out to family and friends. It's like, no, we should keep doing that on a consistent basis in the good seasons and in the bad seasons. You know, everything in life happens for a reason, but it's our responsibility to figure out why everything is happening for a reason. And also, to take it a step further, it's your responsibility to find out your individual part in all of this. What can you do as a person to help better your community, regardless of like where you live at or your larger community and network and your community at your job and also the world economy? What individual part can you play in to affect all key pieces, you know, in your life? You know, always be a giver, never be just a receiver. To kind of wrap up everything I just said, you know, it's our responsibility to play the cards that we've been dealt with. You know, life isn't fair sometimes. It gives us good cards, it gives us bad cards. But it's our responsibility at all times to make lemonade out of the lemons that we're given. You know, you never grow in your comfort zone. There's always room to grow, you know. So, you know, I think this is a good chance for us to grow individually, as a community, as an economy, as a country, as internationally, as a whole planet, to really grow mentally, spiritually, logically, emotionally, mentally, physically, grow in every aspect of our daily lives. You know, this is a good chance for us. I know the circumstances aren't the best, but you never grow from your comfort zone. And sometimes the comfort zone can be a pandemic as such as this, or bills being, you know, stacking up against you. We never grow from our comfort zone. It's always when we're uncomfortable is when we grow. And I think it's time for us to finally accept living in a world and a life where we should make being uncomfortable comfortable, living in that constantly.
But on the other hand, if you're feeling bold, I mean, those plane ticket prices are cheap, man. I myself was like actually thinking about, you know, just taking trips somewhere, because like ticket prices are just so cheap right now, obviously, because fears of getting coronavirus by going, you know, different, like overseas or in just different states. Also, another reason is that like the price of oil is actually going down, so that's why you might be seeing like prices going down at the pump. So you might be paying like a little over $2, or I see a lot of places under $2, especially like I think I heard around like Fairfax, Virginia, near me, like prices like I think it's also like $1.77, which is like I haven't heard that since I was like maybe like 10 years old. But yeah, so if you're feeling bold, you're just like kind of like, man, I want to go somewhere, but I don't know where to go. Plane ticket prices are so cheap. So if you want to let it fly. All right, and then I guess the last topic we can get into is just, you know, this personal, I guess, society stuff is pretty much going on, like how the, you know, I guess the more social media interactions or more of a, like how to like understand society, kind of like figure out like where do you stand. So for example, so like what I'm trying to get at is pretty much saying that obviously social media is a big thing in society now. Pretty much like just have a big social media, or like I said, social media influencer. So, I guess it kind of considered me and my kind of essentially kind of our maybe social media influencers, and we are like YouTubers. So, well, I take the back. Basically, more our content creators. But like, there's tons of people like social media influencers. But okay, what I'm trying to get at is pretty much saying that, people, I guess people are too reliant on social media. People trying like try to do a lot, try to be a different person on social media just to get the cloud up, try to get their, you know, their name out there. But at the end of the day, just continue to just be yourself, just to be yourself on social media, be yourself in society, because honestly, society trying to make us try to be like something different, so try to be something that we're not, try to be something that we are accustomed to be. And at the end of the day, it's kind of like a PSA, just be yourself at all times. Things are in favor, you meet people that you're or born to meet with, that God put you in to be with, to meet. And every person you meet might not be your friend for too long or at all. Like, God put things, you know, in motion to help you, help guide you through life. Like, you might need somebody for that moment, for that season, or for that reason. You never know. So it could be good. It could be good reason. It could be bad reason. Could be showing like what to for you what to avoid, like the person to avoid or the situation to avoid, or it could be showing you things or signs of where you need to go next, like that detour. Like you're on your path and it's like, oh, you need to take this detour to an even better path, to even a better road. So that's like literally like they said, like just continue to be yourself. Stay focused and don't make every encounter that you make that could be good or bad, like just like, man, like why this happened to me? Like why is this? Like why is that? Just think about saying, like, hey, this is definitely could be a lesson. Not an L, it's a lesson. So I'm not sure if I definitely know Malachi wants to, you know, add more to that.
You know, for this next part, I want to introduce a quote that I've came across. I don't want to be a product of my environment. I want the environment to be a product of me. You know, I think that we have to filter what we're feeding our minds. And in this time where I think that we need to really dictate what we're following on social media. And this world is a technology-driven society, but use that to your advantage. You can either wake up this in every morning and scroll through a bunch of negativity, toxicity, violence, death, nudity, you know, people just mad at the world, people talking bad about other people, but it's, you chose to follow them, you're chosen to like that, you're chosen to retweet that, you're chosen to feed into that. You know, you can easily unfollow those people, block people, mute people, you know, do that on a consistent basis. You really need to watch what you grow. You know, if you don't, you know, always be informed of the world events going around you in your community, in your city, but you don't have to listen and watch that, you know, negativity and toxicity on a daily basis. You know, waking up and just reading that your first time scrolling the social media and the news, like, you know, wake up, you know, read some motivational posts, read some biblical scriptures, or read something inspiration, or text someone, you know, some inspiration, or, you know, do it with your friends or your family. Like, start changing your daily habits and your what you're feeding your mind daily. And people, you know, don't understand that anything you do manifests. You know, if you're just watching all that toxicity and negativity, that's 9 times out of 10 is going to trickle into your daily life, your romantic life, your professional life, your friendship life. It's going to trickle down into everything, and you're going to start acting what you're feeding your mind. And, you know, it's our time to really to grow. And a lot of people fear growth. A lot of people don't like when you grow, especially our family and our friends. They don't like it when we start to venture out and do things that are against the norm or unconventional, or do things that they wouldn't do, and they try to hold you back. But sometimes in life, when you grow, you have to do things that other people have or other people have achieved. You have to follow that same suit, but your family, friends have not achieved that. So you can't follow your friends and your family in the entire life and expect to get the results and successes that they never reach or even try to reach. It's not going to work that way. And sometimes people take that personal, and some of those people, regardless of close family or friends, you gotta let them go. Even on social media, if you gotta follow people, someone takes that to heart and doesn't want to talk to you anymore and disassociate you with permanently, then okay, that's fine. But if they can't understand the underlying reason why you want to follow them, then they don't need to be a part of your life anyways. You know, I think that, you know, we don't have time to be comfortable. We don't have time to just be stagnant. You know, your comfort zone will kill you. You know, if you're not doing anything in life, there's only an enemy. Either they're for you or against you. That neutrophil doesn't exist. I don't believe in neutrality, because even if you're neutral, if you're stagnant over time, that's gonna kill you. And it's gonna, and I mean by kill you, not kill you physically, but it's gonna wear you down. It's gonna regress all your progress, because stagnant water stinks. You know, you have to either use it or throw it away. If you just let it sit out, it's gonna be stunk. It's gonna stink, and it's gonna spoil everything else. So if all you're going to do is be stagnant in your life, you're literally spoiling your own self. You're spoiling your own growth and potential. To go any further, I think that we need to develop, you know, a consistent, positive mental attitude in everything that we do. In everything that we do. From a society perspective, from a personal perspective, from a community's perspective, from a professional perspective, relationship perspective, friendship perspective, a consistent positive mental attitude in everything we do. I think that we allow our reactions, our negative reactions and negative emotions to dictate our lives too much. I know I have in the past, and even to this day, and other people as well, but we can't allow the negativity and toxicity of emotions or other people or actions that we can't control dictate what we can control in our daily lives. You know, your positive mental attitude is something that you can control at all times, every day. You know, and the last thing I want to say is, stop fishing in the wrong place for happiness. You know, you really have to sit down and relax and realize whatever I'm doing or wishing for or following or manifesting in me, is that really true happiness for the long term, or is that just short term to mask my short term pain? All that short term stuff is going to go away eventually. You really have to dictate you're fishing in the right place for happiness, for long term sustained happiness and growth. You know, and life is unfair. At all times, not at all times, but life will be unfair at times for you, and especially with this corona thing going away. But you really have to sit here and ask yourself, you know, why is this happening? You know, to tie this into a spiritual perspective, you know, God is trying to get us into position for something. You know, in the Bible, God had put a lot of people in bad positions on purpose. You know, and what happens is, if you listen to what God said, He's gonna get you in position. If you read what He said, He's going to get you in position on purpose. But if you read a little further, what He's saying in the end, not what He said, but what He's saying in the end will get you to His promise and get you to your blessings. You know, He's going to put you in the position to realize what you need to do and put you in certain situations to grow. And then realize what He's saying at the end of everything else in the scripture and in several Bible stories is the promise and the blessings on the other side. However, if you pray away everything that you're going through, and you want to pray away the storms, you want to pray away everything that's not going well in your life, then you're not going to be in a position to grow and be in a better position at the end to receive all your blessings and recovery and growth and development and knowledge. You know, if you pray away the storms, you're going to pray away the growth. And you're going to pray away the success and the blessings. You know, so don't pray away your blessings away. And the last thing I want to leave you all with is a new quote, or a new concept I've learned very recently called no weak faces. You know, at all times, never show your emotion, never show a weak face. You know, from a sports perspective, you know, to say if you banked a shot and it was a losing game or whatever, you're not performing well or anything like that. And, you know, if one teammate shows disgust or shows a weak face and you see that, you're going to feel bad on your own. And then that's only going to make you perform worse. And then from there, other teammates are going to see you performing worse, and they're going to show weak faces. And now it's from that one person, now the whole team is discombobulated, and now they can't, you know, work. And that goes into your personal life. If people see around you and your family, friends see you showing that, it's going to affect them. It's going to make them think that their life isn't worth, that they're not worthy of you anymore. Especially if you have a boyfriend or girlfriend, they see you always down, they're going to think that they can't make you happy anymore. And that may or may not be the case. But that's sometimes how we think. And when people are close around us, when we think that, you know, their life isn't well, that we sometimes have a part in that. And, you know, it's all a trickling effect. So just showing no weak faces, or even strangers, if strangers see that, you don't understand how that can affect their daily life. But also on the flip side, when you show a strong face at all times, people see that, people gravitate toward that, and then people mimic that. So I think that, you know, it sounds a little unselfish, but I think that the more we show our stronger faces and keep our composure at all times, we're literally helping those around us become better and stronger people consistently.
All right, guys, and that is it for the video. Thank you so much for watching. This definitely was a fun video to do. I'm just happy to, you know, finally get collab going with Malachi. He's a really good dude. Great channel. Don't forget to subscribe to his channel. And don't forget to like, comment this video as well. So, like, I think, like, shoot, they want to give a hit a like goal. I said, like, 20 or 25 might be right. I think the most likes I got on the channel was 20? 21, I think, was the most likes I got on the video on this channel. So, I say let's go for 25 likes on this video. Get this video nice, so many views. And, again, so blessed for y'all to be watching this channel. Our channel is so blessed to be, you know, making content for y'all. Y'all have been supporting the whole time. So, thank you and God bless.
Yes, thank you, Nate, for this collaboration and setting all this up. And you know, it was definitely a great opportunity to speak my mind and hear yours and piggyback off of one another to reach both our networks and communities to get our points across. Just thank you to you. Now, please follow him back and subscribe to him and like his videos. And thank you all for your time and hearing both of us talk. I just ask for the same, and you know, follow, like, subscribe, comment below, share to friends. We'll be posting this on my SoundCloud and my podcast through iTunes as well, so stay tuned for that. And until next time, stay up to date with Nate, stay up to me, and my channel, stay put up. Thank you all for your